this video, we'd like to show you the differences between a quiet town in the Highlands, Aviemore, the capital city of Scotland, Edinburgh, and a large out-of-town housing scheme called Wester Hills, which is where we live. We will start with Aviemore. When our group went on a trip to Aviemore, these are some of the differences we discovered. For instance, there was no graffiti, there were lots of activities to do, there such as the water slide at the Landmark Centre, the Flying Fox, there was forest where you could collect wood to make a campfire, there was no gangs to bully and annoy us and to stop us having fun. There was lots of fresh air and you could smell natural things such as trees instead of cars. You could enjoy all the natural wildlife such as the squirrels and the birds. In Edinburgh city centre, there are lots of tourists who visit the capital each year. This causes lots of pollution and traffic congestion. There are department stores which make lots of money from the tourists, such as Jenner's. The historic Edinburgh Castle is the main tourist spot in the centre. There are museums, galleries, theatres, football grounds, Tynecastle where Hearts play, Easter Road where Hibs play. The train station is located in the city centre and it's easy for people to get to Edinburgh from other parts of Scotland. There is a major festival every year in the summer and that brings even more tourists and money to the capital. In Wester Hills, where we come from, approximately 5 miles from the city centre, there are lots of high-rise tower blocks, concrete and wasteland, which is dangerous. For example, Wester Hills Drive, which is near a railway line, it's not safe for children to play here. There were places built such as Murrayburn Kickabout, but that just got vandalised and it's not very safe to use. There are holes on the ground where you can easily trip and get hurt. As the kickabout is too dangerous, we go to the Pits, which is a place to play football inside town. The Pits is good because it's got facilities, but the bad thing is it costs money to get there, whereas the kickabout didn't. Also, to get there is a risk, as you have to go through Sight Hill, and there's a chance you'll get beaten up. Kids get bored and write graffiti everywhere. Even our proper graffiti, which was specially done for Wester Hills Carnival. In Wester Hills we have places to go to after school, such as Whale, which is a place for all ages. It has different groups for different interests, such as a photography group, art groups and drama groups. Another good thing about Wester Hills is that we have good schools like Hailsdon Primary and WEC. WEC is not only a school, but it's got other out-of-school facilities such as the public swimming pool. Next door to it is the Woods Youth Centre, which runs youth groups. Then just a few hundred yards away, there is the Wester Hills Centre, which has got new shops, a new cinema, a new library. The library cost £2.4 million to build and has computers, the internet, you can hire CDs, and it's a great place for young people to go. The cinema has 8 screens and was opened in July, making it easier to get to see the new releases. There's a new cafe open called Cyberbytes Cafe, which allows you to have something to eat and to use the internet. Now you can see the difference between a place like Aviemore, the capital city, and a community like Wester Hills. In Aviemore, you are isolated from people. In Edinburgh, you are surrounded by people, mostly tourists and visitors. In Wester Hills, you are amongst people you know. Thank you for listening to us.